Without question, one of the biggest downfalls of the GH5 is that people tell you the autofocus totally sucks. I'm using it right now. How does it look? Let's find out. Howdy folks, this is Shane. Welcome to the channel. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe and also click that little bell. Now, right now I'm using the autofocus on my GH5. I'm also shooting with a 25mm 1.7 lens, and I love this lens. I think it looks great. Now, this lens wasn't always the best with prior firmware versions with autofocus, but I think it's pretty reliable now. I'll also find if I use the kit lens, the 12-60 or something like that, it works even better, but I'm gonna use this lens because I really believe that this sort of one-point autofocus is by far the best. So I set a little box up, and I've got it basically here, 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 and here. I usually try to aim it at my chest slightly and just a little bit on my face. So if I decide to hold something up to the camera, it's gonna shift focus pretty reliably. I'm looking at my reference monitor. If I bring it back down, it's gonna snap back onto here. Now, one thing that I don't like is the face detection mode. In my particular case, you can see I got some posters behind me. If I shoot across the opposite direction, there's even more posters with faces as well. And I think sometimes it picks up on those faces on the wall. So if I was to get out a shot here, this particular face, depending on the angle of the camera, that would actually be in focus. Now you can see that this focus has actually shifted back to the white zombie poster there, which is awesome because I'm actually out of the square. If I was to hold this back up, there it is. It's in focus, it's not pulsing. You can see there's no pulsing on the screen, maybe just a fraction, but nothing noticeable. Since the Panasonic 2.4 firmware upgrade, I've probably produced 100 videos with this new firmware, and I love it. This one spot autofocus is great. Even if I was to move forward, let me just check. It's in focus. Hold the camera. Look at it again. Check my reference monitor. Make sure I'm not embarrassing myself too much. And I move back. It works. This is by far the best mode. I haven't got any particular custom settings or anything, so I'll show you some B-roll of that as well. But overall, this works. And like I said, if you're using the 12-60 kit lens or one of the other lenses with a wider angle, it tends to be even more reliable. I do a lot of guitar videos on another channel. I've got over 2,500 videos on that channel. And being able to move, say, the guitar in and out of focus, which I might do actually, is pretty cool. So I'll show you. See, it works. Put the headstock over the box. Headstock becomes in focus. Put the guitar back over the box. That becomes in focus. And I'm back in focus. I'm looking over here because I got this big reference monitor that I use just to make sure everything's working. I think that's still an essential part of it. I've tried face detection mode a few times on this Geeky, Nerdy, Techy YouTube channel, and it's let me down. I had to actually add B-roll over it. So for my money, I think one spot autofocus mode works the best. I've got a pretty cluttered background and I don't see it really doing anything too distracting. Unless the topic of the video is relating to autofocus, most people won't even look for it. On my guitar channel with over 100,000 subscribers, I've never had one person say, hey, the focus is pulsing. Not one. So you can take or leave that. My situation shooting here at home might be a little bit different to everyday life, for example. I got a lot of posters on my wall and you can see this one right here. Depending on the angle of the camera, if it's up a little bit higher and it sees more of that face, face detection mode will wanna lock onto that as well. It will get a little bit confused. So yeah, if you do have a lot of posters of people's faces and so forth like I do on my walls, face detection mode probably isn't the best mode. And I do find if you're shooting with a light source behind you, even like this computer monitor, you do see that pulsing. But on one spot mode, I'm looking at my reference monitor right now. I don't really see it moving at all. And like I said, you can move nice and close. I'm making sure I'm over the actual square. It should still be nice and sharp. It is pulse, it did pulse a little bit there, but I always find it's one of those things with this camera and the way that the focus system works. If you're basically, if you set up the square like I have and you stay over it, it's nice and simple. If you're also behind the camera, you can change the focus point or where you want that square to actually be positioned, and it will sort of track the object in that area. I think this is by far the best mode on the camera, and after shooting hundreds of videos with this camera now for the last 12 months, even through all the different firmware upgrades, this is still my favorite autofocus mode. Like I said, you can hold things up. it will latch onto it at some particular point in time. A little bit slow there, but because, there we go. I reckon it's got something to do with this contrast base autofocus. Definitely struggles if something's just black, but if it's got a bit of white in there like that, or a bit of color, it will see it a lot quicker. Let's just try this again. Yeah, I don't know, I think it works fine. And like I mentioned, if you're taking it seriously and you shoot at home, having a reference monitor is absolutely essential if you're on your own like I am. Every now and then I'll just look at the reference monitor. I usually have it behind the camera, but I'm shooting in a different sort of angle here today. So I'm checking it out and I think it'll be okay. Let me know what you think, honestly. Is it distracting? Are there problems with the autofocus? Some people will say that everything will be out of focus because that's what they see. I edit all of my 4K content on my iMac and I can also view it on my Acer monitor back here, which is a 4K monitor as well. I never really think and watch it and go, you know what? There's pulsing in the video. I just think it looks good, but you let me know what you think. Thanks again for watching, folks. My name's Shane. This was a quick follow-up video from my initial quick test where people said, you need a little bit more in the background to see if it was stable and all that kind of stuff. I think it's pretty stable. Let me know your thoughts. Thanks again for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and I'll catch you soon. See ya.